The newly crowned NFC champion Seattle Seahawks are the second youngest team ever to play in the Super Bowl. They are competitive, they are confident, they are all in. The organization's values headline their walls. And for some Seahawk teammates and coaches, an impassioned belief is branded in their hearts.
We're not just Seahawk players, we're not just football players, but we're here for much more than that. We're followers of Christ. And it's important for people to know this about us.
No matter what happens in this game coming up, you know, it'll be nice. You know, you wake up happy if you win, you wake up kind of disappointed if you lose, but ultimately you're still the same, but Jesus changes us forever. And Jesus is the greatest treasure of all.
Dr. Carl Payne has been the Seahawks chaplain for 20 years. He's at the 30-yard sideline on game days. During the week, he meets with team members and is a full-time pastor at a local Seattle church.
There's too much of an image that if you love Jesus, you're soft. And our players are far from soft, and our team is far from soft, but we have a core of people that love Jesus dearly.
Regardless of a player's chapel attendance, Carl commonly serves as confidant and inspiration.
It's just good to know a guy like Carl, man. He just keeps me going, keep pushing me, and it just motivates me every week.
NFL players, coaches, and staff work in a unique profession. As chaplain, Carl is player appointed, required to give discreet pastoral care.
Encourager, trainer, somebody who tries to give the players tools that they can work with. They're to serve them. They assume everybody is trying to use them. If you do not develop trust, you will not work with athletes. It's everything.
This season, Carl has watched players mature deeply in their faith, several who are team leaders, and many who have become outspoken in their convictions.
They have been willing to stick their neck out from the get-go. They want to be at Bible study, whether people approve or disapprove, like it, don't like it, sticking their name out, their reputation out, saying, we're going to do this and let people know. This is a platform God has given us. We're going to use it for His glory.
This weekend is football's biggest game, and the stage has expanded dramatically.
Being missional, constantly looking for opportunities to tell people about Jesus, and that's really what it's about. And that's what the hope of our team is. You know, if the brothers on the team, that we want to do well so that ultimately we have a platform to talk about Jesus. You know, and really, that's the best thing that we could ever do for anybody.
We want to win, we'll play to win, but this is about a platform to 130, 140 million people whose church on Sunday is in the NFL watching a game. And if we have a chance to become their church, even if it's just an opportunity for them to go, there are guys on both teams that love Jesus, that's a message we want people to hear.
That platform comes with a captive audience. And here in Seattle, the raucous 12th man has been there all season long. So a handful of players and coaches wanted to craft a message letting fans know what they believe and why. They paid for and participated in a DVD production of all things called The Making of a Champion. As it turns out, that championship title is now well within reach.
Started filming during training camp, and I mean, obviously we didn't know at that time the kind of season that we were gonna have now, but I think it's pretty cool the way that it's worked out.
Clint Gresham is the Seahawks long snapper. He pitched the idea to teammates after hearing that a Brazilian soccer player passed out a DVD of his Christian testimony at the World Cup. The Seahawks' Making of a Champion was distributed after a home game last October and has since moved to the web and gone viral.
Clint Gresham approached me and he said, why couldn't we get some of the Christian guys on our team to help people understand, here's who we are as players, but here's what motivates us as people. We are not football players who happen to be Christians. We are Christians who happen to be NFL football players.
We wanted to use the platform that God's given us to share our faith, and you know, everybody worships this God called the NFL, and we want to introduce them to the real King.
It's really just us using our avenue where we're at to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ.
An avenue runs from 12 Seahawks Way, leading to the heart of their city and beyond. For quarterback Russell Wilson, it's a road that's paved with purpose.
Russell, we know you to be prepared. We know you to be poised. How does your faith carry you?
You know, in terms of my faith, you know, I believe that I'm here for a reason. you know, and that's what I told the guys. You know, I believe that we were in the NFC Championship for a reason. I believe that God placed me in this city for a reason. You know, that never wavers for me. I'm going to trust that the Lord's put me here, and I'm excited about the game. You know, I'm excited about it. I'm excited about the moment, and hopefully it's the best 60 minutes of my life.
You know, now we're in the Super Bowl. You know, this is a dream for me as a child, and to be living it, there's no better opportunity than there is now. God had every day planned out for you, and that he knew every struggle, he knew every pain, he knew the things that you loved most. And in that, he set a purpose specifically just for you. And it's so refreshing to know that, and to know that, you know, God's on your side, and to know that he's for you.
In Seattle, they're redefining what makes a champion.
Understand that the eternal perspective has to trump things of time. 3.4 years was an average NFL career. The walk with Christ is going to last a lot longer than the other. When the tinsel and the confetti and stuff are done, it's me and Jesus. The price of your soul was the death of the Lord Jesus. If the price is the same, then the value is the same. They're locked on that. Well, they understand that in the context of winning or losing. I am valuable because I belong to Christ. End of story.